Have you ever wondered what a black hole sounds like? Well, NASA has you covered. All right, so joining us now to make sense of what we just heard is...
Sounds like my stomach rumbling.
Right? Seriously. is Professor of Theoretical Physics at the City University of New York, Michio Kaku. He is also the author of The God Equation, The Quest for a Theory of Everything. Professor, what did we actually just hear there?
Well, some people say, now, wait a minute. A black hole is an object so dense that even light itself cannot escape. So how can sound escape when even light itself cannot escape? What you're actually listening to is vibrations. Vibrations created by the black hole rippling through the gas cloud. These vibrations are then picked up on the planet Earth, massaged by a computer, amplified by 57 octaves, boosting it so that we can hear it with the ear. So you're not going to be able to go outside and go like this and hear a black hole from outer space.
But what does it mean to scientists, to those of us who aren't just listening to the clip of it? What is the significance of it?
Well, it means that black holes are no longer science fiction, that we can actually see these things in outer space, measure them. If you want to, quote, see a black hole tonight, go outside, look in the direction of Sagittarius. That's the center of the galaxy. In Sagittarius, there is a black hole, weighs 2 to 4 million times the mass of our sun, and we on the Earth are actually moving around that black hole. And you can see it tonight in the constellation Sagittarius. So this is not just science fiction anymore. We can actually see these things. We can actually, quote, hear these things if you boost the signal, of course.
Right. Don't try to listen tonight. You're not going to hear it exactly. It doesn't work quite like that.
Right.
I want to show you all a picture now, and the subject of cool and amazing in new technology. This is a picture of Jupiter from NASA's new James Webb Telescope. Scientists are saying, quote, they didn't expect it to be this good. What's exciting about what we're looking at right there?
Looking at an image with light gathering capability from the Webb, 10 times greater than the Hubble. And you can actually see rings around Jupiter. Look very carefully. And you can actually see not one, but several rings going around Jupiter, which are totally, of course, invisible from the planet Earth. Plus, look at the North Pole and the South Pole. You can actually see the aurora with electromagnetic radiation barreling down the North Pole and the South Pole of Jupiter. These are details which Hubble cannot see, because Hubble has a blind spot. We forget that. The Hubble telescope can see ultraviolet, can see optical frequencies, but infrared frequencies, not so good. While the Webb Space Telescope specializes in the infrared frequencies, and therefore this is a map of Jupiter that we've never seen before.
And what else do you expect from the James Webb Telescope? Or is there anything that you're in particular looking for?
Well, so far we've found 5,000 planets going around other stars, but we don't have detailed photographs of them. We just see the shadow of them.
Yeah.
Now we're talking about actually photographing planets going around other stars in the universe. This is incredible. Think about that.
You have
Plus,
me excited.
We're going back to creation itself. The Webb is a time machine. We're talking about pictures of the earliest galaxies and stars formed almost 200 million years after the Big Bang itself. So we're talking about going back to creation. Back to when the universe was a baby.
Professor, always great to see you. Thanks for getting us so excited about what we're seeing and sort of hearing.
Thank you.